Next up on Yo TV, we have some really, really good stories. One of them is how a place where you can make really cool stuff out of metal. So check it out next on Yo TV.
Yay!
Hello,
hey.
How's it going? Hi. Evening, people. Such a great day. It's a beautiful day. He's having a good time. I'm having a good time. My spirit animal's here. Hers is here.
Mine's is a pigeon, and we're all just chilling here in Jack London Square, downtown Oakland. We got some cool stuff to show you guys.
Some great stuff. Really great stuff. Really, really exciting. But right now, we're going to go into a clip from a place called The Crucible.
In West Oakland.
They
do a lot. They do a lot of stuff with fire, which is my, I'm a pyro. But they also make jewelry. They make rocking chairs. Everything. They make underwear. Just go check it out.
Video brought to you by eBasey. Check it out next.
We the only ones with work in the middle of the drought. Them niggas round the corner come and see what we about. But we don't know they pay, so we don't want them by the house.
Let's get. Welcome to the Crucible. I'm gonna show you around.
Come and see about me. Come and see about me.
This is the neon area right here. This is where you make, you know, like all the signs in Las Vegas and everything. And this is woodworking right here. This is where you make typical things like chairs, dressers. You can make like little rocket cars. You can make a lot of stuff here. Like you can make carvings like that over there. You can do all different kind of stuff here. This is a really cool workshop. My name is Mike Brown, and I'm 13 years old. And I am in the youth program, and I'm also an intern. And I am in the youth advisory committee. This is right here, glass fusion right here. This is where you clump glass. Like you cut the glass and you glue it together. I learned like science and everything, and you also learn art. Hey y'all, this is the jewelry class right here. This is like where you pretty much, you know, just make your jewelry, you know, so you can bling bling. This is where you anneal. You have to anneal like before you even shape it, you have to anneal it first with a torch. Before I started this program, I was pretty much like on the streets and everything, like hanging out with these battle kids and everything.
Right there. Harder.
Good. Stop. All right. It's like clay, but that means that you can't use your hands with it. See, it's like it's pretty easy. It's not hard, but it takes a little while to get used to it. You know, like all the scale and everything, it falls on your skin, and then you know.
I spend like 3 to 4 days here, like 4 to 6 hours every day that I come.
Right now they're tapering out the medals for the bench, and I was helping JT over there. Find me, drop me up, boy, and get your face. This is the oxyacetylene torch cutting area. This is where you cut metal like with torches using two gases, oxygen and oxyacetylene. Oxyacetylene is a real flammable gas and is real unstable.
Good job.
Like they real nice and everything, and it's like they real good teachers, but except like their classes is boring and everything. And then it's like if you mess up like one little time, then they start hollering and you baby all in your face, spitting, and they breath be stinking and everything. And here it's like the teachers, they don't be doing that. It's like they be all nice and kind and everything. What I want to do is I want to go to college, and I want to try to get like a sports degree, and it's like if I get injured or something like that, then I would be able to have something that I would be able to do, because I wouldn't be able to play the sport anymore. Like my dad told me, like diving welders that be like weld the bridges and everything, like they get like $400 an hour, and I was like, whoa, that's a lot of money. So I was like, yeah, I want to do that. My dad, he's a landscaper, and he's take me to work with him and everything. So I got real interested in it. Then it made me want to become like an engineer or something like that.
Never gonna stop trying to get it through. Never turn
off. Thank you, Mike, for your time. For showing me around.
No problem, anytime.
Don't go anywhere. Youth Outlook will be right back. But right now, the train is passing. Everyone salute.
Black Report is a radio show where we document and bring up a lot of the issues affecting the black community.
Who's all here to decolonize the mind today? Who's all here for revolution?
I'm calling the police. I want the FBI to arrest me.
Arguments about money usually drown out the tech flash.
Trying to get us frustrated. Get us frustrated before you.
His family sued the federal government because of MK Ultra and his murder.
Right there, you know what I'm saying? It's been real, man.
And if you think that's conspiracy hysteria, acuérdate of the school of America.
Get that monkey off your back. Get that monkey off your back. Get that monkey off your back, boy. Get that monkey off your back, girl.
Get your sprawl!
Sprawl Magazine is a quarterly publication dedicated to giving much-needed representation to the many diverse groups throughout Northern California and beyond.
Get your sprawl!
Sprawl Magazine covers the events and stories that youth want to hear about, such as employer rights, political awareness, our friends and family coming home from war, and cool new artists such as Amy Malkoff, The Secret Sons, Gavin Freitas, and Sarah Ramos.
Get your sprawl on.
In giving a voice to our often misunderstood community, we break the molds, tear down the stereotypes, and empower a fast-growing population. So get your sprawl on. Now available through participating schools, or log on now at sprawlmagazine.com.
Step up to the mic, San Rafael's hottest new youth center. Only at the mic can you learn to make your own movies, record your own CD, or learn to cook amazing cuisine. Contact 415-459-6884 or just stop by at 1115 3rd Street in downtown San Rafael.
Hope you enjoyed that last clip. Hope you learned some really cool stuff about metals and fire.
Yep. We're still out here at Jack London Square hanging out with my close personal friend Jackie, aka yes. Jack London himself. He's deep in thought right now.
He's
but
not much of a talker, really.
I can get him to talk.
Could you?
Silly. Great author. But right now, we're going to show you another great author, a musician, a poet of poets, Beat Rock.
Beat Rock. He could be the next Timbaland. I'm not saying anything. Could be.
He's a piano man, but yes, not indeed. The kind Timbaland was talking about. This guy's talented. And he's coming up next. Yo TV.
Really, like God, dude. Like when it really hit me that I was given a gift. Like I watch people practice and like really put all their heart and soul and just be trying to do hard stuff. And like the stuff they'd be trying so hard, I'd do it so easy. And it really hit me like, man, it's a gift. So he gave me this gift, I should just use it to the best of my ability. And that's one of the things that drive me every day is the fact that I was blessed with this. You know, it wasn't something I really even had to really work for. You know, I put the time and effort to perfect my craft, but it was just given to me.
I'm working on my scary movie music, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Everybody be thinking I just be doing a little beats and a little, you know what I'm saying? It's more to me than that. We doing that film scoring, we doing major things. Just want to show love to everybody out there in MySpace land, you feel me? I'm back at it again, doing some new stuff, trying to reinvent myself. You know, you ain't never just been watching the movie at the house when that music kick in, when the white girl about to get killed, you feel me? And it just... And then she almost gets killed, but she tripped, and then she get back up, and then start back. And then she start running through the woods hella fast. And then the carry dude come out of nowhere with a big ass knife, and it just be like... trying to catch her, and he's like, you feel me, moving around. Then he get to the other part where she hiding for a minute. Then he walk by, he think he see her, and she be like she about to say something herself, but she don't quite, you know, just a little bit of doo-doo come out of her booty, cause she be scared. Then the music come back on. Then she drop something, or make a noise, or sneeze, or some dumb ish, and now he know where she at. So the music come back like...
So that right there alone was just enough reason to just do it, because I'd be doing him a disjustice if I wasn't to use my talents that he gave me to help impact this world. And I mean, you know, you got your artists out there, you got the Pharrells, the Timberlands and all that. And you see dudes doing it and doing something positive, people that's, you know, doing something that's not so negative. And that's just something that I see we ain't really got too much of out here. We got something, but it ain't like it should be. And, you know, hopefully I'll one day be that dude we seeing on just on a national level that's like from here. Feel me? I ain't never gonna move away and act like I ain't from East Oakland like some people do. Feel me?
So we're gonna go to commercial break. While we do that, you check out newamericanmedia.org. A lot of good stuff on there. See you when we get back.
Yo, TV.
Hey, Donnie Lumpkins here. I'm standing outside of Cal. This is the MLK building. This is the line to go and vote. It's pretty long. It's like a madhouse here. It's like really, really cool atmosphere. We're going to try to talk to some people, so stick around. Who did you vote for this election?
I voted for Clinton.
And I ended up voting for Obama.
I voted Hillary.
I voted for Barack Obama.
I voted for Barack Obama.
Barack Obama.
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 Hey, really quickly, who are you voting for?
I think I'm going to vote for Obama.
Big surprise. Who are you voting for?
Obama all the way, baby.
Obama all the way. How about you? Voting?
Right here.
Obama.
Obama all the way.
Obama all the way. One more.
Oh, I already voted for Obama this morning.
Already
I'm
voted.
A new kind of politics.
Voted for Obama.
Obama. How about any?
I'm from Hawaii, so I'm going to vote in the primary for Obama.
Sweet. Obama.
I just voted for Obama.
Obama. How about you?
Huh? I voted Thursday.
Who'd you vote for?
Obama.
There you go. Barack Obama. It looks, I don't know, it's pretty one-sided out here. 5 out of 5 dentists say Barack Obama. What is it about Barack Obama that made you want to vote for him?
He brings people together, you know. I really feel that he really has a message of hope, and he seems really authentic.
He stands for what I, like, want, like, equally injustice.
He's for change, and as far as supporting the, like, education, that was one thing, one of my main concerns.
What was it about Barack Obama that made you feel like you could vote for him?
He resisted this war from the beginning.
He said something at one of the debates that resonated with me when he mentioned that we should talk to our enemies. And Hillary said, no, we shouldn't talk to our enemies. And I feel like whoever becomes a president is going to inherit the war and has to deal with our enemies.
How about you? Why Hillary?
I think she has a pretty amazing, unprecedented record as a politician. I think she has a wealth of experience.
I watched the debate online and I thought she was the most eloquent. Well, actually, I thought Edwards was the most eloquent, but he dropped out of the race, so I voted for Clinton.
Did race or gender play any part in your decision?
No. If I wanted to play for gender, it would be for Hillary, obviously.
Race and gender plays a part of, I think, decisions that we make on a daily basis, so of course.
No, I don't think so. Maybe gender, but I don't know.
To some extent, but I think that, again, both Democratic nominees would do well, so it was not a tipping point.
To a small degree, the fact that he is a black man is not lost upon me, but I don't think his race nor Hillary Clinton's gender actually would make a difference in terms of their competency to hold the office?
It did in a way, because I actually, that's one of the reasons I didn't want to vote for Obama, because I thought about how a black president will be perceived in some countries. And so in a way, it kind of added to my analysis of who to vote for. And Hillary is such a strong woman, you know, I mean, besides all her, you know, political resume, she's done so much as a woman, and she's so strong.
I'm here talking to Jeff. He's out here like just like everyone else. Tell him what happened, Jeff.
Well, I registered to vote, and I received a nonpartisan absentee ballot to vote on. So I was able to vote on all the propositions that are up, but I was not able to vote for a candidate, and I'm very upset about that.
So it's kind of goes without saying, but do you think voting matters? Does it count?
That's a tough question. I think it's tricky how they organize the counties and the districts for the voter representation, for the delegates. Definitely. I'm not even too clear on how they decide super delegates. Mm-hmm. So I think it's a pretty foggy process. I think it needs to be way more transparent.
You feel like your vote counted?
I hope it does. You know, I mean, with all the kind of the mucking about that the Democrats and the Republicans have done with the kind of electoral process, you know, it's a proportionate electoral vote for the Democrats, and it's a non-proportionate electoral vote for the Republicans. I kind of feel that a lot of Americans have a false sense of actually what their vote means.
I definitely do think my vote counts. I was almost not gonna vote this election, thinking that it's okay. Everyone else is gonna be voting, and everyone's pretty much for Obama, so my vote probably wouldn't count. But I kind of re-reflected on that.
This is actually my first time being able to vote. I just became a citizen less than a year ago, and so I've been really excited to vote. And yeah, so this is kind of cool for me, just to be part of this process. I hope my vote counts.
Out of all the people we talked to at Cal, seemed like overwhelming Barack supporters there. Let's see if that can carry over in the actual results. But the jury seems to be in here. Barack Obama all the way.
My name is Donnie Lumpkins, and 70 hours ago, approximately, a monster attacked the city. No, I'm joking. I am going to vote. I'm going to vote right now. Hold on, give me a second. This is a polling place. I'm going to vote. First time voter, very excited. Let's see see what I can do in here. I don't know. Seems to be this way.
It's all right, Obama, here. Obama.
There you go.
Obama, Obama, Jama, Obama.
Obama, Jama, there you go.
Let's go for a change, baby.
See how far I can get into this place with a camera. I don't know. No restrooms. No smoking. It doesn't really say no cameras.
So I walked in with the camera. Everything was fine. And then I got in there and I turned it off just because I wanted to like open it while I was at the voting booth thing. But the lady kind of, she snuck up beside me and was like, "You can't have that in here." So I got scared. A little confusing for a second. I didn't know how to yet kind of draw a line from the tail of an arrow to the point of an arrow. Kind of weird. I was expecting like fill in boxes. It was good. It was fun. Got my voter sticker.
Hey, we're about to go, but check out CYMC.org. They brought a lot of videos this episode, and they have other stuff up there. Cool Kids, Conscious Youth Media Crew. Check them out.
But hey, I wasn't about to be in the back. You know, I wasn't about to look at his tail lights, man. I didn't want to know what his tail lights look like.
Want to stay up to date on what goes on with ethnic and youth media? Visit the New America Media Bookstore. You will find writing and art from homeless youth, literary journals from the Mian community, DVD on mental health advocacy, and much more. You can even subscribe to any of our youth publications or New America Media's directory of over 2,000 ethnic print, online, and broadcast media. For more information, visit www.newamericamedia.org and click Bookstore.
So, Donnie, you rode your bike down here, right?
Yeah, I did. It goes down my bike.
Are you going to get a car?
I'm thinking about it. Not quite sure yet. You know.
I don't know. I have a car, but how do you buy a car? My mom kind of handled it for me.
Well, it's good that you asked, Jasmine. CYMC is going to show us what to do when looking for a car. New one, old one, used, brand new. They're going to tell us what to do.
Americans spend thousands of dollars on cars every year. Are you looking to buy a car? Saving up for that sweet ride on the lot? It's all about you and your lifestyle. Things to consider. How far and how often are you driving? How are you paying for your car? Where will you park? What's the budget for extra costs? For example, car repairs, parking tickets, gasoline. How will you insure the car? Which car is the right model for you? Research car models. Consider the year of the car. What type of car suits you and your lifestyle? Use the internet to find out information on different models of cars. Test out the car. Should you buy a new or a used car? A new car would be more reliable, superior in quality. It will include a warranty. Know that a new car will depreciate once it is off the lot by 20 to 40%. A used car is always a better deal, but it can be risky. It might be good to consider for your first car. You may be able to get a limited warranty. To avoid dealerships, you can purchase a used car from your family or from your friends. Try to find an expert mechanic to check out the car before buying it. Before going to a car dealership, take financial matters into your own hands. Remember, the more money you save for a down payment, the lower your loan amount. Call your bank or credit union for a rate quote before visiting the dealership. Find out your own credit score either online or through the mail, or visit annualcreditreport.com. One thing to remember when buying a car is that you're the boss. Prices are negotiable, so always find out your information first. When buying a new car, gather information on the model you're interested in. Check the wholesale prices online. Compare dealership prices. Never buy at sticker costs. Get help from car buying services. Used cars can be risky, but worth it. Stay on top of the situation. Check Kelley Blue Book value. Use Carfax.com. Check online.
Good time today.
We sure did. We had a lot of fun out here by the bay, sitting on the dock.
Jack London is awesome. I haven't spent too much time over here, but I really, really like it. A lot of good stuff. It's Barnes & Noble over here, movie theater, chicken and waffles. How can you resist?
That's where you can find me at.
Indeed.
But check us out next week.
We'll be back, but in the meantime, if you're craving for something, like I'm craving for some chicken and waffles, check out youthoutlook.org. Maybe you'll blogger, see a lot of good stuff on there. See you guys next week.
Peace.
All right, let's go. Hit that whistle. Let's put that whistle in there. One time. About to sample that, yo. Sitting on the, all right.
Ooh, I'm just sitting on the back of the bay, watching the time roll away.
Anyway, ooh, we're gonna watch the time roll away. We have to go to commercial break, but we'll be here singing, having a great time while we're gone. You check out NewAmericanMedia.org. It's an amazing time. Go ahead. Give him the whistle.
I can't do it anymore.